icon for more notifications.
So now let's see what are last minute preparation tips. Last minute preparation tips for ESET. Okay. First thing is just analyze how many days are left for exam. For example, if you are left with only 2 days for exam, completely you need to schedule that 2 days. Okay. So that 2 days, prepare a timetable and make sure 60 to 70% of the timetable should consist of your weak subjects and weak topics. Weak topics and weak subjects, okay? In subjects which you are not confident in the topics which you don't know properly, concentrate on those topics, okay? This is first preparation tip, okay? Next is, you need to prepare short notes. What is short notes? Maintain a small book while reading physics or while reading mathematics or chemistry or in fact any subject. Coming to chemistry, if you read any important equation, or coming to mathematics, if you read any important formula, immediately you need to note that formula in the short notes. Okay. So why I am asking you to maintain a separate short notes is just before the exam also, you can just open that book and go through a quick revision. So coming to mathematics, we already know formula is very, very important. Only when you remember the formula, only you're going to solve the problem. So maintain a short notebook and revise it thoroughly every day. Okay. So whenever you're going to take a small breaks in between your study sessions, just go through those short notes and have a quick revision. Okay. Attempt mock tests. Okay. There will be many mock tests. Just attempt them. And after, why I am asking you to attempt mock tests is, once you give mock tests, you will understand what kind of questions are coming, how we are solving the paper, and in which subject you're getting stuck, in which question you're getting stuck, and how is your time management. All these things you can understand only after giving mock tests. Okay, so first give mock tests, and after giving mock tests, make sure you analyze your mistakes and don't repeat those mistakes in final exam. Okay, so next is solve previous papers. Previous year's papers are really important. You will understand what is the difficulty level of the questions which are appearing in the exam and what kind of questions are asked in the exam. All these things you can understand only by looking previous papers. Okay. So, and next important tip is, don't start new topics. Don't start new topics. See guys, you already know if you are left only with few days of your exam, don't start any new topic. If you start any new topic, you'll be confused what you read already. Those topics also you're going to forget. So that's why don't start any new topic. And next is concentrate on high weightage topics, high weightage and important topics. Whatever topics I gave you as important or a high weightage, concentrate on those topics, okay, in order to get a very good score in your exam. Next important thing is time management. Manage your time wisely. Time management is really important because you have a limited time and so many questions. So don't waste your time. Before going to exam only, fix your mind how much time you're going to give for single question. After that time, just automatically go for next question. Don't waste your time just by getting stuck with single question. Okay. Next important thing is, before your exam, on exam day only, make sure you put all your required things at a place so that on exam day there will, you need not panic searching for the documents, admit card and all. So now let's see what is ESET cheat codes. First important cheat code is avoid extreme values. What is this? what is meant by avoid extreme values. See, for example, there is a question and there are four options. Option A is 4, option B is 3, option C is 6, option D is 22. Okay, so see, these are all single digit values and these are near. Option D is completely different. It's a double digit value and it is an extreme. So when you are trying to guess the answer, don't go for extreme values. Correct answer is going to be out one out of these three, but not 22. Always avoid extreme values while you are guessing the answer. Okay, the important thing is use elimination method. What is elimination method? Coming to the elimination method, when there is a question and when there are four options, try to, and you don't know what is the correct answer, then try to eliminate irrelevant two options. Okay, using the concept which you know related to that question, use your concept and use your common sense and make sure you eliminate at least two of the options, and out of the rest over options, one you can just put as your answer if you don't know the correct answer. Okay, so like this, you need to use the elimination method and you need to eliminate irrelevant options so that it will be easy for you to guess the correct answer. Okay, next important tip is all of the above and none of the above tip. Okay, so what is all of the above, none of the above tip? If you don't know the correct answer and if you see one of the option as all of the above, go for it. There will be high chances of all of the above being the correct answer. But if you see none of the above is correct, one of the option, don't go for it. Okay, all of the above has high probability to be the correct answer. None of the above has very low probability of being the correct answer. Okay guys, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. All the very best for the students. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends, and thanks for watching.